Can move on to the next content block, that is external content. So external content block helps us to fetch the content from external server or from external website. So let's say if I'll type www.google.com, then what it will show me, it will whatever the current content is available on this particular web page, it is going to fetch me that thing and show it over there. But we don't generally use this external content block because it always has some issues with the styling and all. So based on the capability of the email message, it can only render the HTML or maybe some part of the CSS. But when we open this page in the browser, then it will open up all the CSS and the styling and everything. So what it does, it basically fetches all the HTML code from the page from google.com and load it over here. So whatever can be rendered, it will render, but due to the capability, if something cannot be rendered, then it will not. Okay. So this content block is used to fetch the external content from external website or external server. We have two different methods to for the retrieval. The first one is the immediately. So whatever the content that is appearing right now, that will be sent to the subscriber. The next option is the send time. So this URL will be executed at the send time. So right now, let's say I'm configuring this and I want to send this email tomorrow. So if I want to show the content that is appearing over here right now, then I will choose the immediately. But let's say this content might change tomorrow. So what I'll do, I'll choose the send time, and whatever the content that will be present at that point of time, that will be fetched from that particular site, and it will appear over there, and then it will be sent to the subscriber. So we have two different ways for the retrieval. So let me just save the changes now. Let's talk about the layout content block. So layout content block is generally used when we want to form a structure. So let's say on an e-commerce website, you must have seen that we have an image, and next to the image, we have some description, we have some price, and then we have, let's say, add to cart button, right? So we always have this same structure whenever we are placing something. So in the email message also, we can have the same structure, right? So when we are placing the same comment box in the same fashion, then what we can do, instead of dragging and dropping them one by one and on the email message on the email template, what we can do, we can choose one layout, and let's say this one, and we click on the select button. And then what we can do, we can have two different comment box over here. We can save this layout, and every time we want to choose this, we can do that. So let me show you another layout that we generally use. So you must have seen whenever we receive the email message, it generally has one brand logo and then the hero image. So instead of utilizing them one by one, what we can do, I'll click on the select button, and here we can have, let's say, a band logo. So I'll choose the band logo over here. Let's say this one, and okay, and I'll have one more image over here for my hero image. So I'll click on the browse button and I'll select another image. So what I want to do in each and every email message, I want to include the brand logo and then the this hero image. So I can just save this layout, and instead of selecting this one by one, I'll say layout demo. I'll save this, and after that, so in the text message now, now what I can do, I can just directly drag and drop this layout, and then it will contain both the blocks. So let me delete this one for now. And I'll go to the content and I'll drag and drop this layout content block. So if you want to have multiple content blocks in one, if you want to, you know, form a layout so that we don't have to repeat the same thing again and again. And if you want to, you know, form a combination of multiple content blocks in one structure, then we can go ahead with the layout content block. Let's talk about the social follow. So social follow content block helps us or helps the organization so that the subscribers can follow them on their preferred social media network. So let's say if company's account is available on Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn, and they want the subscribers to follow them on the social media platform, let's say www.facebook.com/NTO. So let's say this is the Facebook page of the organization, and then they want to follow this. Okay, so we can just have the link over here, and if somebody clicks on this, they will be directed to the Facebook page, and then they can follow from there. So we can add all the social media networks that we have available over here. Let's say Pinterest, Instagram, and those things. And then we have the icon styling. Either we can have this or maybe this one, this black and white, or maybe the small icon, something like that. And then we have the block settings where we can add the background color, padding, margin, and these things. So it looks horizontal, like it looks better in horizontal layout. So social follow helps you or helps a subscriber to follow the organization on the different social media platforms. So I'll click social follow. Next one we have is social share. So the difference between the social follow and the social share is using the social follow, the subscribers can follow the Twitter handle or social media, like follow the organization on the on different social media platforms. While in case of social share, it means that we are going to share this email. We are going to share this email content on our social media platform. Okay, so here you can see we do not have any link over here. Because whenever somebody will click on the Facebook, they will be redirected to their own Facebook account. And from there, they can share this email content with their friends. Or maybe on the Twitter, they want to share this email content, or they want to forward this email to a friend. So that is something they can do. Or if you want to share this email with on the in the LinkedIn. So whenever they click on this, it will open their own Facebook account. And then we will have this email message in the form of a link so they can share this. Now, if somebody clicks on that particular in a post on the Facebook, then they will be able to see the content that we that is sent to the subscriber. Okay, let's save this. So should we share?